Sawadeekrap, my name is Osbecker Hooker, and today I am making a video in response to a request made to my Facebook page. I use 3.5 meters worth of a 70-pound shock leader, and that is for three reasons. Firstly, the giant snakehead has really sharp teeth. If you were to encounter a giant snakehead of a large size and it takes your entire lure into its mouth, you're going to want to have a strong shock leader to protect your line from being cut by its sharp teeth. The second reason is abrasion. When a giant snakehead bites your lure, there's a high chance it might just drag your lure into some woods or some rocks, as they usually do. And when this happens, your line will have to face a lot of abrasion, and a regular braided line might not be able to handle it. And thirdly, I like lifting my fish into the boat. What I do is I swing the fish back and forth like this until it's tired, and then when it is, I lift it up into the boat. The thing about using 3.5 meters of 70-pound shock leader is that at that length, you still have that leader line still in your reel, meaning there's no braid while you are lifting the fish into the boat. However, there is a problem with using 70-pound shock leader. When tying a 70-pound leader line to the braid, you're going to create a really huge knot and it'll get stuck in your guides and your reel. And that's why I would like to introduce the FG knot. The FG knot is considered to be a knotless knot. The idea behind it is that we have a braided line wrapped around the fluorocarbon leader many, many times without creating a proper knot. What we're going to need today is an old rag, your fishing reel with your braided line inside. In this reel, I'm using a 40-pound braid. And this is the 3.5 meter shock leader I was speaking about. And here I have some pliers to cut the line. Alright, well, let's start tying this knot. To tie an FG knot, you're going to make sure that your braided line is always tight. Otherwise, the knot will fail. You're going to want to start by holding the reel down somewhere to make sure that the line is tight. Here I have the reel underneath the table, under my feet, to make sure the line is tight. So first up, you want your line nice and tight. And then we take the shock leader and cross it over the line like this. And then we take the tag end of the braided line and wrap it over the shock leader like this. Then you do another wrap, but this time with the base of the line. So now we have two wraps. We're gonna want to get up to 16 wraps. Some people only go with 12 wraps, but me, I like my security, so I'm gonna go with 16. So this is 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. As you can see right here, I want to keep the wraps really tight and close together. Push it with your fingernails if you have to. Once your 16 wraps are nice and tight, we're going to want to pinch them. And now we want to tie some half hitches. To perform a half hitch, we start by folding the line under both the leader and the braided line like this. And with your fingertips, put them into the loop from below and then grab the tag end and pull it through. And as you can see, the half hitch will go over both the leader and the braided line. Now this time, we're going to make a half hitch going over. So we fold it above, put your fingers into the loop from above, pinch the tag in, and pull it tight. Remember to lubricate your knot with a little bit of saliva while doing the half hitches to make sure they stay tight. Keep alternating the half hitches between folding below and folding above. And now a third one, we fold under again. And remember, folks, everything's got to stay nice and tight for this knot to look good. And pull them tight. Now the fourth one. A little bit of spit to keep it lubricated. Now pull it tight. You know what? I'll go with 5 half hitches, you know, just to be sure. Now we're going to use that rag to wrap around the main part of the braided line. With a rag, wrap that around the braided line to prevent yourself from getting cut. And with your other hand, hold on to the leader line and pull really hard. Pull it till the knot is tight. When you pull it really tight, the braid will cut itself into the fluorocarbon, pretty much fusing the two lines together. And after that, we're going to tie some half hitches onto just the main line to prevent the line from coming out. So this time, the half hitch goes over only the braided line. So here we go. Half hitch at the bottom. Half hitch above. Pull her tight. Now with some pliers or scissors or whatever you need to use, cut the excess braided line as well as the fluorocarbon line. And at this point, you can cut the shock leader as short as you need it to. And there we go. And this is the FG knot. And please observe, you run your fingers through both lines like so, very little resistance between the two. As you can see, when you crank the line into the reel, the knot goes smoothly in, even with a low-profile bait caster. And when you cast it out, the knot just comes straight out. Minimal resistance. If you're going to talk about any other line-to-leader knot, like the Albright, if you're to do that with a 70-pound leader line, forget about it. It's not going to go straight in your reel. Yes, so this is how you tie the FG knot. I would like to end the video here. My name is Oz Banker Hooker. Sawasdee krap.